know, front foot across. That's stupid. You know? The Lord was crucified on the cross. Everybody looking around and like it's some piece of armor.
It's an Egyptian symbol. It is the arm.
Like that Egyptian arm.
Yeah.
Going back to
Tamu. Now you can go back to Babylon.
So what's your denomination?
Return unto the Lord thy God and obey his voice according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children, with all thine heart and with all thy soul. And then the Lord thy God will turn thy captivity, will have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations whither the Lord thy God has scattered thee. And I was talking about Israel right before they went to the promised land. So this was a future prophecy that will take place centuries later, even thousands of years later. You know what I mean? Because right after the Deuteronomy and all that, going into the book of Joshua, they go into the land of Israel. They weren't scattered yet, you know what I'm saying? Moses was telling them, y'all gonna be scattered. But yeah, your boy had a mountain. Everybody got priorities, you know what I mean?
This is Ezekiel 11 and 16. Therefore say, thus saith the Lord power, although I have cast them far off among the heathen, and although I have scattered them among the countries, yet will I be to them as a little sanctuary in the countries where they shall come.
Yeah, right here in this country, this is that little sanctuary right here.
So out of those on the list, 144,000 is going to be from those.
The 12 tribes of Israel. When you go to Revelation, the 7th chapter, it breaks it down for you beautifully. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, the 144,000, that's the elect. That's men. That's like the government of Israel.
Right. Men.
But you're going to have other, you're gonna have the one-third also that's going to be saved.
You're the elect of the elect. The 144,000 is the elect of the elect.
The elect of the elect.
Right, right. Like you said, the governing body.
What
right.
did they, Revelation calls them? The first fruits. They will be the first ones to make it up out of here.
You know, in this world, if you're going to jump on your ass, you come home with another one.
They're going to be virgins.
Yeah, they're going
to
be virgins.
Oh, yeah, that has to be. That's the law. Because the law says if you have sex with a woman who's not a virgin, has been with another man, technically that's adultery. That's a sin unto death.
So we're all adulterers.
Right?
Right.
That's why you got to pray to the Lord.
Right, right.
Absolutely.
So, we're, go ahead, bro. My bad. I'm going to
You said 144,000 gonna be virgins.
Yeah.
Like 200 men right
you
here.
Said they have not been defiled by.
Well, that's not virgins.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the women.
That means.
You said they have not been defiled by.
I got
that's Revelation. That's talking about philosophy.
I got a scripture to break that down for you. Paul talked about that. It's 2 Corinthians 11 and 1. Would to God ye could bear with me a little in my folly, and indeed bear with me. For I am jealous over you with godly jealousy. For I have espoused you to one husband, that I may present you as a chaste virgin to Mashiach, Christ.
It says
Christ. 2 Corinthians. So we supposed to prepare ourselves as virgins. But that's, you know, that's a metaphor, because we know Peter had a wife. You know what I mean? The disciples all have women, and we know that they're the top guys. You know what I mean? King David had all kind of women. So what it means is you got to be pure as a virgin, spiritually and mentally, in your mind. That's what it's really talking about. Oh, yeah, that's another.
Y'all heard of it.
Then shall the kingdom of heaven be like as 10 virgins who took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom.
It was a little
virgin. Because we're also, like you said, we're espoused to the Lord. He's the husband. You know what I mean? Israel's the wife.
I'm gonna take offense to that.
Hey, get that scripture in Jeremiah when it talks about that. Yeah, it says this woman.
Yeah.
Where's that at?
Is it talking about the righteous? Is that 100,000 men righteous?
Yeah, that's in
righteous women.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. He's saying that it's just hard to find a true brother. Of course, it is. You remember, like, you probably can tell. Yeah, okay. So, you can't go fucking back.
In that sense,
there was a time when you walk the streets, man. You hear it all the time. How you doing, brother? Brother? Oh, let me get that shit. Oh, I got it.
I got one right here real quick. Jeremiah 6:2. I have likened the daughter of Zion to a comely and delicate woman. The word of daughter of Zion, you know what I mean? Israel's referred to as a comely and delicate woman. Who's that one?
I got Jeremiah.
Yeah, that's pretty okay.
They say if a man put away his wife and she go from him and become another man, shall he return into her again? Shall not that man be greatly removed? But thou hast prayed the heart of needy lovers. Get returned again to me, saith the Lord.
That's talking about Israel playing a harlot following after them other gods' philosophies.
So, okay. Hey, I appreciate you.
Yeah.
That's
right. You be out here.
You see us out here every Sunday.
Yeah, that's what's happening.
Right.
Yeah, all right, all right, brother.
Diligent. And see where thou hast not been laid with, and the ways hast thou sat for them as the raving in the wilderness. And thou hast polluted the land with thy whoredoms and with thy wickedness.
And you see too, when you walking around out here in these streets, as you just see nothing but wickedness flourishing out here, because our people have polluted this whole land with their wickedness. You know, you got women walking around in that real proud spirit, they can do whatever they want. They listen. I was listening to this Beyonce song. She had this song. It was going, it was like five boys, pick up the minute. The whole song is about leaving her man.
Oh yeah, I know.
Now we need to do a
I
whole
saw the video.
We need to do a whole video breaking that down, man. Because this is the most evil, most adulterous, satanic shit I've ever heard in my life. And that's what all these women listen to. You know what I'm saying? They listen to that music. It's talking about adultery. And they just adultery.
And they fall into it.
I don't know, I heard it on the
sound. Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah, sorry. It's awful, bro. It's the most wicked, most evil shit I've ever heard in my life. I thought she was married to Jay-Z. So she telling him bye-bye and sorry or whatever. That's an agenda they push them in the music industry. They put that spiritual vibration on these women to put them in that spirit of adultery. That's what the whole purpose of the music is. It does. The music's a big deal, man. That puts a heavy spiritual vibration out there. Because really, music's like a spiritual weapon that the devil uses on our people.
And he finishes, therefore the showers have been withholden, and there have been no latter rain, and thou hast a forest forehead, thou refuses to be ashamed.
A lot of people say that too. We was talking about how you're supposed to prepare yourself as a virgin. Because you got a lot of preachers in the churches, and a lot of people don't say that the 144,000 are actual virgins. You never have. First of all, there's no such thing as a man virgin. Only a woman can be a physical virgin because her cherry gets popped. Okay, a man ain't got no cherry. You know what I'm saying? What kind of shit is that? You ever seen the scripture where it's talking about men virgins? It don't never say that. That's a woman is a virgin, but because Israel is like a comely and delicate, beautiful woman, so we're likening them to a virgin because we're supposed to be pure.
Again, I will build thee, and thou shalt be built, O virgin of Israel.
O virgin of Israel.
Thou shalt again be filled with thy child, and shalt go forth and dance with them, and they merge.
And that's clear, man. So you got a lot of clowns out here. They don't know the scripture. They just going into the Bible and just winging it, just making stuff up as they go. And they got no kind of spiritual discernment. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, these pastors don't know what the hell they're talking about. Teaching that bullshit just so they can get your money.
I think everything is literal.
Yeah. And that's why atheists always attack the Bible. They'll be like, oh, that's why the Bible's bullshit, because it's talking snakes. See, that means you got no kind of deep thinking process going on, bro. You know what I mean? You ain't thinking on no deep level. because the serpent in the Garden of Eden was talking about a man. It wasn't an actual snake. Snakes can't talk. I mean, how stupid you gotta be to believe it, you know what I mean? And there's scriptures and songs that compare the wicked man to an adder. I'm gonna get that. Yeah.
This is Isaiah 29 and 9. Stay yourselves and cry and wonder. Stay yourselves and wonder. Cry ye out and cry thy own. And cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink.
Yep.
For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep, and have closed your eyes. The prophets and their rulers, the seers, have he covered.
Yes.
Comfort and charge.
I was getting coffee this morning.
Good Lord Almighty.
That's a bad day to be drinking coffee.
Come on, bro.
But yeah, that scripture, we gotta get it, man. That last part. Yeah.
Stay yourselves and wonder. Cry ye out and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink. For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep. It hath closed your eyes. The prophets and your rulers, the seers, hath he covered.
Right, because the majority of our people are in a deep sleep. They don't know what the hell is going on. They're just totally clueless. They ain't got a clue. They're going with all these pastors, the leaders, politicians. You know, a lot of these politicians is in the dark too. They think they got some power. They ain't running shit. You got people behind the scenes running shit. Everybody out here is just in a deep sleep. They just got no clue about how the world really works. They got no clue about the truth. That's because the Lord did that to them. The Lord put them, you know, so the Lord put them to sleep. Right, you see, they just act ignorant as hell. You know, ain't nothing good about them. They got nothing to contribute to the rest of the world. They just working, bro.
They got nothing to contribute to the truth.
Exactly.
You know, you're righteous.
But they hate the truth. If you try to teach them any truth, they gonna gnash their teeth at you. You know what I mean?
And the vision of all has become unto you as the work of a book that is sealed. You know? Like yep. I said, they can't add on to this. You know?
Yeah, because the book was sealed. The seals was loosed by Yahweh Shai. You know, if you ain't calling on the name of Yahweh Shai, you ain't never gonna understand it. You ain't never gonna understand that book. You know what I mean? It's point blank period.
Which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this, I pray thee, and he saith, I cannot, for it is sealed. And you know what? There's some pastors actually meant that too.
They told me that when I was, I went to a Southern Baptist church down there on High Street, South High Street. Southern Baptist Church, bro. I remember Pastor Dan, I asked him about Revelation because I was reading it.
Pastor Dan.
And he told me you're not supposed to be reading that. That book's sealed. You know, just because he can't break it down, it's sealed.
Right. Hey, the apostle's still waiting for Dr. White to break down, Deuteronomy 28 chapter, man. He said he was gonna come back and make a beautiful video and say he was gonna break it down.
Your dude James White's disqualified. He celebrates Christmas.
Dr. James White.
How you call yourself a scholar, but a believer in the Bible on a scholarly level, but you celebrate Christmas?
Well, I bet he's gonna see
Christmas. Well, that's what I'm saying. So show me in the scriptures where it says to celebrate Christmas. Show me that December 25th date. Because it's got dates for the holy day. You look in the book of... You look in the book of Exodus, it's got the date though. Oh yeah, it's nasty. You see what I'm saying though, right? How there's dates in the Old Testament, and it tells you on this day you do this, you celebrate this holy day.
Yep.
So Christmas ain't in there, bro. But James White celebrates Christmas.
Halloween.
Easter. So that dude's not serious, man. He's not a true believer. Go ahead.
For it is sealed, and the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he said, I have not learned. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth, and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me, and their fears toward me is taught by the precept of men.
Yeah, the precepts of men. These people is not following the commandments. I bet you do. James White would say it's okay to eat pork too. He's like, it's okay, brother. We're having a nice Christian sausage and eggs breakfast dinner. We're going to have a theological discussion. Man, they shoot music videos, bro.
You're kidding me.
They was doing it back here, too. Probably some rap, R&B bullshit. Oh, shit, what the crap? Oh, my fault. I'm spraying it. Hey, there's a festival, like a giant community yard sale.
Right now?
Going on in on the south side, close by his house, kind of.
Oh, wow.
Over on Hanford. You know, there's like a little park right there by that Catholic school.
Right.
It's like a big ass community yard, so they got tents, music. I ain't never seen it right here.
I want to finish more of this here, man. Therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work among this people. Even a marvelous work and a wonder, for the wisdom of their wise men shall perish, and the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid.
Right, yeah, because these so-called wise men out here, you're going to find out they don't really know what the hell they're talking about. They just got some degrees. They'll use a bunch of fancy words that they practice for hours to memorize. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he had a whole wardrobe with him. He said, God died. What a fucking retard. But he's going to be the one that actually died, though. The Most High is forever and eternal. That's just that proud spirit. So your boy just going to get, he just condemned himself by saying that. You think he cool and shit, bro. Oh, vain ass spirit. I think he's slick. How slick he gonna look, bro, when worms are eating his ass? You know what I mean? You get ate by worms and maggots that crawl through your eye sockets. He ain't gonna look so slick then. Or when you get hit by that missile, you just get turned into a pile of ashes.
That's the simplicity.
Yeah, simplicity. That's what's... Oh, go ahead.
Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are in the dark. And they say, who seeth us, and who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay.
Oh, like you do the last week, where the dude about to say he's going to kill him for fucking his wife?
Oh, yeah.
He thought he hid his sins, and nobody's going to find out. Yeah. Right, you commit adultery, you do some faggot shit. People are going to find out. Like that dude, he called your boy out last week and just let the whole world know the dude was a cocksucker.
Dude was just stuck.
Yeah.
Stuck.
He fell stupid as fuck.
He didn't even say much.
That was beautiful, man. That was the work of the Lord right there.
He made me not to show the things for himself for him to bring me. He did not understand. That's it on that.
Go ahead.
To me with their mouth, and honoreth me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. But in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines that the commandments of men.
Right, that's all these people. They claim they love the Lord. They be like, I'm a child of God. They get child of God tattooed on them. You go on their Facebook page, it says that you can post the scriptures with the sunset in the picture. You know what I mean? They're claiming how much they love the Most High, but they commit adultery, having abortions, eating pork, celebrating Christmas. Just doing everything wrong, getting nothing right. You know what I'm saying?
And none of your works in the days of the Lord.
You're talking, only God can judge me. You know, that's how they be saying it.
We are God.
Exactly. We're the judges.
That's why they, that's how you know they're on the stage.
That's being...
God can judge me. So right. Esau can't be out here and read precept after precept.
Right, then why did Paul write all those letters correcting all those churches? 1 Corinthians. He said he called the Galatians foolish. He said, oh, foolish Galatians.
That's a righteous judge. Yeah. But God.
Hey, let me get that for you. Because it actually says that in that scripture. Psalms 82. Actually, let me just read it all. Psalms 82:1. God standeth in the congregation of the mighty. He judgeth among the gods. How long will ye judge unjustly and accept the persons of the wicked? Salah. Defend the poor and the fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and needy. Deliver the poor and needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked. They know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness. Ain't that our people walking in darkness?
Yeah.
All the foundations of the earth are out of course. You can see everything's out of course out here. You know, the whole world has been turned upside down. Now it's okay for men to beat women, you know what I'm saying? Men marrying men. Shit's just crazy. It really is getting worse. This is an everyday occurrence. Everywhere you go to the store, get checked out. The cashiers are training. And if you say something, oh, that's hate speech. Yeah, you don't want them fingers, no. You know what them fingers have been doing? You don't want them nowhere near your food, bro.
I saw you.
I'd be scared.
I no longer go to restaurants.
I saw her.
Yeah, that shit ain't right, man. Where it is, Psalms 82:6. I have said ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. But ye shall die like men and fall like one of the princes.
That's right, because we ain't got that power, you know?
And this is the point talking about judging people. It says, arise, O God, judge the earth, for thou shalt inherit all nations. So how do you inherit all nations? If the Lord is coming to save all nations and all people, and then how are we going to inherit all nations? What does inherit mean? That means the nations belong to us. All them heathen nations out here in the world, that's our property. Leaven's the whole lump. So if somebody comes up here just saying something little, bro,
I don't know.
And he's like, it's not a big deal. Why don't you just get along anyway?
That's that little bit, huh?
Right.
That small matter that most people just look over like, oh, it's a small matter, man. That motherfucker got to change your own with that matter. So spread that matter.
Right, it's the old saying. If you give them an inch, they take a mile.
They add on to it, too, don't they?
Right. Now they know they can get by with something. Now they're going to get by with something else. Next thing you know, they teach them flat earth.
Here you go. No ye not that the Lord is God. Know ye not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life?
For real.
Then ye have judgment of things pertaining to this life. Set them to judge who are least esteemed in this earth. I speak to you, saying, it is so, that there is not a wise man among you, no, not one that shall be able to judge between his brethren.
Yes, so we are to judge people. That's the problem with the earth, is there ain't no judgment. That's the problem. And the so-called, hey, the so-called judges in the courtroom, they ain't judging according to the scriptures. And then when people, they tell us we can't judge, but they don't never tell the judge that. Why don't they go in the courtroom and tell, you know, only God can judge?
They go in the courtroom and sit there in fright.
Yeah, they'd be scared to death. Yes, master. Yes, sir. Yeah, but our people are a joke.
Proverbs 31:9. Open thy mouth, judge righteously, and plead the cause of the poor and the meek.
It's really good.
Yeah, just, oh, that's almost the same word. I'll go ahead, read that.
Proverbs 31:9. Open thy mouth, judge righteously,
and plead. Yeah, right, you gotta judge righteously according to the scripture. You can't be making up your own judgments, telling people that a man is only allowed to have one woman his whole life, or teaching whatever kind of stuff they be making up.
Isn't it crazy when you run into a brother that actually teach that?
Yeah, or they make up another script. They'll make up more laws like you can't have sex until you're married. That don't even make sense. That's an oxymoron, because according to the scripture, sex is marriage. You know what I mean? They're nowhere in the scripture said that we was ordered to have this long ceremony, putting rings on fingers, going to the courthouse, signing the documents. That shit ain't nowhere in the scripture. And then when the preacher marries you, what did they say? By the power vested in me, by the state.
By the state.
They said by the state. And not by the Most High. They say by the state.
Here you go, this is Revelation 22:18. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book. If any man shall add unto these things, the Most High shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book.
Oh yeah, another one too. Another scripture they be trying to add is trying to say you're never allowed to drink or consume alcohol. You're not allowed to drink beer or wine or no whiskey or nothing. They made up that commandment. That's nowhere in the scriptures. So y'all gonna have to pay for your lies. Here it is, all the disciples drink wine at the Last Supper. And you got these retards saying, you're not allowed to drink. How stupid are you? You can't do nothing.
All thing you can do is bow down to Caesar.
What is the scripture that talks about the liberty that we have in your house?
The liberty, right. Liberty that these women are supposed to have.
Yeah, oh yeah, the woman, yeah, she ain't supposed to have all this liberty, run around acting wild. They run around like stray, like feral cats. You see them feral cats, they be out in the alleys, bro, out in the woods. It just multiplying. You go out in the middle of the alley in the night, there's like 500 cats. That's how our women are. They out there on the prowl at 3 in the morning roaming the streets.
Can't fight.
Yeah.
That's all they do, bro. They hate each other.
And yeah, I see more and more prostitutes every day. You go up and down Main Street, boy, they're everywhere. Don't even go to the west side. I think almost every woman on the west side is a prostitute almost. Like, you go down Sullivan, bro, and you always see a different one. They had a sting about a couple of weeks ago in the bottom of the prostitute. They took a bunch of them to jail. Yeah, it was like 100 of them or something. High number, right? But you go back and you can tell they was gone. It was, they had ones ready to jump up and take their spot. Just an endless stream of whores that you got.
Finishes 19. And if any man shall take away from the words of the prophet of the book of this prophecy, the Most High shall take away his part out of the book of life, and out of the book of sin, and all the things which are written in this book.
Yeah, so, I mean, you out there teaching that madness. That's another new commandment saying the Lord came to save all nations. Ain't nowhere in the scripture said that. So all you fools teaching that madness, y'all gonna burn in that lake of fire. Y'all gonna eat those missiles. Because, you know, back in the ancient world, if you got caught breaking the smallest commandment, and, you know, you get fucked up. Like I said, if you committed adultery, you get put to death. Now we got, you know, we can be forgiven of your sins, but I don't mean you're supposed to be committing adultery. You know, during when Israel was living in the land of Israel, if you got caught committing adultery, you was getting put to death, no doubt about it. And there wasn't no second chances.
Oh, we give them a second chance.
Nah, you got put to death. That's all there was to it.
What about 50 shekels for you? Just let me go, man.
Oh, that's how they do it now in the court system. You throw some shekels at the judge, they let you go. You post that bond, your $500,000, and they let you go.
Oh, go ahead. Galatians 2 and 5. That because of false brethren unawares brought in, who came in perfectly to spar our liberty, which we have in Yahushua. They might bring us.
Oh, you gotta have a lot of dudes do that too, like in the Israelite camps and stuff. They'll come in the camp, or they might even be the head of a camp, and they be trying to control everybody, you know what I mean? Always. Like cursing at you, just being a dick. Be trying to control your every move, be monitoring to you. I heard a couple stories about dudes doing that. Man. Go ahead.
No.
I got something to read. It's 2 Peter. Actually. I'm not going to read over there. 2 Peter 2 and 9. The Lord knows how to deliver the godly out of temptations and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. That's what we're talking about. Oh, that's the day of judgment. We're talking about judging, right? They said only God can judge them, right? But let them go with that. Oh, yeah, okay, only God can judge them. Okay. Because it says, the Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptations and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. So, yeah, if y'all want to say only God can judge me, all right, then you're going to get punished.
Amen.
But chiefly them to walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanliness and despise government. That's not talking about a United States government. That's talking about Israel. That's talking about the elected Israel. Really, it's talking about us. There's a lot, you know, y'all despise us, that means you despise government. Because we're the authority. Well, y'all was just saying, you gotta let them know with authority. But chiefly them that walk after the flesh, that's all people, they're all walking after the flesh. That's why women dress, most women nowadays, they dress like whores. Just be straight with it. They dress like whores. You can see all their breasts. You can see their camel toe. You can see everything. What's up? It's like you go outside and it's like going to the strip club, just going outside down the street. Like, you ain't gotta go to the titty bar. You just walk down the street.
You ain't gotta waste your money.
And they'll say, they might even start shaking it too. Somebody play some music, all women will lose it. They'll start shaking their booty in the middle of the street. Start rubbing on each other out in public. They just foul. Our people are disgusting.
You gotta do is ask them. Let me see you twerk.
Yeah. Let me see you shake it. You know, do it.
Let me see you twerk. The foulest shit I've seen, man, twerk. Since when are you a woman's ass and your ass is ugly? It made it unattractive.
You because it.
What the what? That's only due to progress on home with your husband, you know?
For real, that's only meant for your husband's eyes.
They let everybody see it. It's for everybody. It's called free advertising.
That's what you call walking after the flesh.
Right. Here you go, this is 1 Corinthians 2:14. Of the natural man receiveth not the things of the spirit of the Most High, but they are foolishness unto him.
All I hear people say, well, you got faggots or something. Just, you know, they'll argue with you. Like, why are you disrespecting our women? They disrespect themselves.
Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judges all things.
Yeah, he that is spiritual judges all things. That's why when we see a whore, we're going to call her a whore. Okay? And we're going to judge all things.
Yet he himself is judged of no man. For who hath known the mind of the Lord, Yahawashah, that he may instruct you? For we have the mind of the Almighty.
Yeah,
these motherfuckers have the mind of Satan.
Right, because the Lord said, you know, we believe in him, and he dwells within us. Exactly. Hey, let me get the rest of this.
They can't understand that, man. The spiritual demon is suffering. You can see. You can see.
Yeah, you can see. I don't know. It's just an evil, wicked spirit.
It's ugly, man. It's ugly.
Spirit. Hey man, it's a curse. Who knows? Maybe at least some Romani's. Or what is that? They look like legit. Get the rest of this. Presumptuous are they? Let me just start over this right here. This is 2 Peter 2:10. But chiefly them that walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanliness. Our people are unclean. You can see them too. They just nasty and clean. They got no respect for nothing. Presumptuous are they? Self-willed. They are not afraid to speak evil of dignities. And that talks about elders and everybody, like, it's a, you know, y'all motherfuckers, yo, they'll talk shit, call his name. So whereas angels, which are greater in power and might, bring not railing accusation against them before the Lord. But these, as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption. Ooh, that's bad. You know what I'm saying?
Things they understand.
And that's why the Lord was on the cross when he said, what? Father, please forgive them, because they don't know what they do. Because really, our people, they're gone, because the scripture told you the Lord put them to sleep, gave them that spirit of blindness. And you can see it, bro. Our people are just dumb as hell. Just fucking retarded. And they ain't getting no smarter. We get tired of looking at these people, man. I'm fine here. I just feel like a giant pile of shit out here just looking at everything, bro.
Shower.
Yeah, you really do. You got a shower out. You try to clean yourself.
Like you said, don't touch a pig. Because you're unclean once you touch it.
Because our people are like another swan.
Yeah.
They're an unclean animal. It's an unlawful animal. Two-thirds is an unlawful. You know what I mean? And let me finish this up real quick. They shall utterly perish in their own corruption, and shall receive the reward of unrighteousness, as they that count it pleasure to riot in the daytime. Huh? Oh, I don't fuck it. Hey, that's... It's like you think you get used to it. You keep seeing shit. Like you say, you see it more and more. you gotta really watch who you're talking to. Now you got transvestites. You can't even tell some of them that look like a woman.
That was a man.
Well, I didn't even see it, but
that was a man.
It's fucking disgusting. That's why the Lord's gonna destroy this country. He's gonna destroy America from off the face of the earth. All this, we got trains walking around. Every other person is a fucking train. Look, why this is a scripture for him. And shall utter, this is the trainees, this is, goes to them, shall utterly perish in their own corruption, and shall receive the reward of unrighteousness. And the people that also that condone it, they're gonna receive the same punishment.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And shall receive the reward of unrighteousness. As they that counted the pleasure to ride in the daytime. Spots are blemishes. Spots they are and blemishes. Sporting themselves with their own deceivings while they feast with
you. They got in front, you know, form. That's your front.
Yeah. Form. Yeah, but they want to kick it with you, be cool with you, but they plot on you.
Cause
there's
no motherfuckers around. I mean, the majority of most motherfuckers is cool with that.
Here it goes right here, look. 2 Timothy 2:14. Having eyes full of adultery. That's all our people right there. 2/3 of Israel, all women, especially the women, they got eyes full of adultery. They've been trained since their birth, you know, by the government, by the schools, by the TV, radio, music, everything. They've been trained since birth to being adulterous. You know what I'm saying? That's what the society teaches you. Having eyes full of adultery and that cannot cease from sin, beguiling unstable souls and heart they have exercised with covetous practices, cursed children. And our people are cursed children, which have forsaken the right way and are gone astray, following the way of Balaam, the son of Bozor, who loved the wages of unrighteousness, but was rebuked for his iniquity. The dumb ass speaking with a man's voice forbade the madness of the prophet. Oh, that's going back to Numbers. All right, it's that one scripture. These are wells without water, clouds that are carried with a tempest, to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. For when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allure through the lust of the flesh, through much wantonness, those that were clean escape from them who live in error. Yeah, because don't they do that? They speak with great swelling words of vanity. Like your boy doing the music shoot. He probably gonna do a rap video talking about he's the greatest rapper. You know what I'm saying? He got all the money. He's got more bitches than you, more money than you, more guns than you. He's the greatest thing on earth. You know, that's what all rap music's about. It's all about the ego. You know what I'm saying? But the Lord's gonna destroy you. Let me kill, I might as well read the rest of this. While they promised them liberty, they themselves are the servants of corruption. For of whom the man is overcome, of the same is he brought in bondage. A lot of men try to put you in bondage. Even when you're in the truth. Some people, like, you got a lot of cults out there. Like people, they try to, you know, get you under their spell and under their control. And then you become like their little slave. They try to get you like Charles Manson had on them bitches. Or like your boy Jim Jones. You got a lot of Jim Jones type people out there. All bugged out. Everybody up in their congregations all bugged out. They'll believe all kinds. Like you do Bubble Eye Blackfish from GOCC. He's got all them people in his church in bondage. Okay? Teaching them about demons in the pyramids and demonic animals. Teach about mermaids. And your dude Nathaniel, he got all of his church in bondage. They all wearing that purple costumes. Now you know those ain't free. You know, he's profiting off of each member of his church. He's banking, you know what I'm saying?
That's what's called the bonds of sin.
The mind, yeah, right. He got them all in bondage.
Refer to somebody as simple, you call them a fool. Stupid.
Just like your boy, you remember the old videos by KOC? You know KOC,
yep.
What's the name of it? Ram? But he made all kind of videos talking about the comforter and how, you know, how he get people in, he made slaves of the whole congregation. They wanted to get that garment, they had to pay like $300 for it. Something. It was expensive as fuck, you know? Oh, that was Bumalai. Oh, no. He took him to Egypt.
Yeah, Egypt, right.
And then that's when that civil war broke out with the, you know, that's crazy. And he still got followers. It tells you how stupid our people are. They'll follow anything as long as you give them a, you know. Hey, bro, he's got a gruesome punishment coming, bro. That's going to be fun in 2 years, bro. His eyes going to get real bugged out when that happens.
Hey,
you ain't see your boy singing?
Who's that?
The GM Bubble Eyes. He was singing. Hey, say, it was not. Hey, dude, was kidding. It sounded like some Disney music. Everybody, it sounded like some movie out of a Disney cartoon.
I'm not gonna see that.
He can actually sing, though. I'm not saying it wasn't that horrible.
I gotta see this.
Yeah, it sounds real gay. It sounds like I said, it sounds like a Disney soundtrack. Some of you have seen, you know, the animated movie. It's like the happy. It sounds like the happy ending in a movie.
Right.
This is all corny ass happy shit. But that's how he lures them people in there. He wearing that nice white clothes. They nice and crispy and clean.
Got him.
You know, got him. They're right. He gonna come and sing the little smooth song. That's the shit the bitches like. They won't hear that smooth shit. I don't even want to hear no shit like that. That's too smooth. That's not even smooth. That's just more. It's just some faggot shit, actually.
Church music.
Yeah. Oh, yes. I like real music, bro. I got to have some guitars and stuff in there.
On receiving worthy counsel of God too. Nevertheless, even those that thou sparest as men in this sin, rats, wolves, forerunners, thine host to destroy them little by little, not that thou was unable to bring the ungodly under the hand of the righteous in battle, but to destroy them at once. I'm going to start at 10. But executing thy judgment upon them by little and little, that gave them place of repentance, not being ignorant that they were a mighty generation and that their malice would breed in them. Like you said, ever since they were born, they were taught this shit.
Yeah, because ever since from day one, you born in this shit. You go to school, because now they got transgenders in elementary school. How crazy is that?
Hey, handle condoms and shit?
Yeah.
Like what?
And they teaching you, giving your children like sex ed classes.
They give you, they have that shit in my school. They give you, what's the shit called? Well, it makes it wet, so you can put it in the ass.
Right. Lubricant.
Yeah,
that's
nice.
Lubricant.
You
can
tell how you do
it in
the ass. Oh, wow. What? I didn't know it went that far.
Just think about them, like the sex ed class.
What?
You know, the teachers are getting off of that. They getting off on it. They're all pedophiles.
See, sex ed was for high school kids back in the day.
They still ain't. There should be no schools at all.
That's crazy, man.
Because school is the worst place and most dangerous place to send your children to school. When you send your daughters to school, guess what? That's when she gets pregnant, is in school. Your children learn about drugs, where at? School. They learn how to go robbing and stealing at school. They learn how to join a gang at school. They get molested at school by the teacher. The teacher jacks off in your lunch at school. Okay?
They get that shit at church too.
Yeah, exactly. All these churches, they none of them churches.
That was the original school, the church.
Yeah, actually, that was the, this is the real schools right here.
Yep, that was the original school, man, but you know.
But all the churches, all these churches now are all set up by the government. That's why they all under a 501c3 tax exempt status. So if you want to have one of these big churches on the corners, you got to play ball with the government. You got to sign a contract with the devil. What do the scriptures say about signing contracts with your enemy? So anybody that's under a contract with the government, they're just sold out.
15 and 16. We have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and your fruit shall remain. What that was good.
Exodus 23.
Go ahead,
so
what you're saying,
you're
about to make a point.
Oh, yeah. Read again. It says, in our danger. I was about to read out because I'm about to go to fucking college to go.
This is Exodus 23 and 32. Thou shalt not, thou shalt make no covenant with them, nor with their gods.
Yes,
they shall not dwell in thy land, lest they make thee sin against me. For if thou serve their gods, it will surely be a snare unto thee. You know, and that 501c3 is just another form of their god. Because how their god works.
Because that means you, because the god of America is Baal.
Put that signature down, you're making a covenant.
Right, and that's all dealing with money and taxes, right?
Right.
So when you're dealing with taxes, but whose image is on the money?
Heathens.
Heathens. And then you look at the symbolism. What's on the back of the dollar? You got a pyramid going back to the Egyptian gods. Ra, Horus. You got the eagle. It's all devil worship. So really, when you sign a 501c3 contract, you make a covenant with Baal, with the devil. And you can see it. That's why all them churches, they're actually pagan symbols. You ever see the church symbol that goes up like a point? It's called a phallic symbol. It's like a needle in all the churches. Not all of them, but a lot of them. They put that giant needle on there because that represents Osiris's penis. That's why the ancient Egyptians had them needles everywhere. They call them obelisks. They have one in Washington, D.C. It's called the Washington Monument. That's the same thing that's on the churches. That's an obelisk.
Isaiah 28:15. Because we have made a covenant with death, with hell, or we had agreement.
Yeah, our people, they have made an agreement with hell. Look, they chose to live in hell. You know, they love it.
With an overflowing scourge shall pass through, it shall not come unto us. We have made lies our refuge, and our falsehood.
They do that. It's that lies is their refuge. They go there to seek comfort. They go to lies to seek comfort. You know what I'm saying? Shelter.
In the falsehood, have we hid ourselves?
That's how they do it, bro. And they'll hide behind that falsehood and lie. And they won't leave. It's like a shield to them. And you know how, like, Yahweh Shai is our shield. Their shield is the devil. Being wicked in wickedness. And they try to justify everything wicked they do to the lie to themselves.
Jesus.
I had a scripture that came to my mind.
Just pay me by 200% tithes and the Lord will love
me. Yes. Money, that's it.
I got another for yourself. This is 2nd Israel 9, and I'm starting at 9:9. Then shall they be a pitiful case, which now have abused my ways. And they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits, they have not known me. And they that have loathed my law, while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not, but despised. Like they despise us. Like the Lord said, they hated him first before they had
him. Oh, yeah. You know?
So all they're doing is just showing that they hate the Lord, his works, you know. They hate him. To them, it don't benefit them because this world they in, that Esau ruling, they receive benefit. Get to ride around their brand new Mercedes and got a six-figure income, you know. 4 or 5 different baby daddies that are receiving child support from, and they're getting a welfare check, and alimony, you know. And they ain't including all the other niggas that got on the side that's paying cell phone bills, car payment,
club drinks.
That's a wicked ass world, man.
Oh my goodness, this is just no end to it, so it's gonna have to be ICBM missiles. That's gonna do some damage to this shit. You know, it's gonna change these things. ICBM missiles. This is crazy, man. Because ain't no righteous judgment for them, because they're ignoring the prophets. They go to their local church, and the prophets ain't giving that. He ain't judging shit right. He ain't reading book.
Look at this.
Oh, this is madness, man.
Psalms 11 and 6. Upon the wicked, he shall rain snares, fire and brimstone in a horrible tempest. This shall be the portion of their cup.
That's right. Since they ain't want to hear the true righteousness, since they don't want to hear true judgment from the men of the Lord,
they going to eat missiles.
You know, kind of what the Lord say, this is how he going to plead with you. Missiles, fire.
Oh, the Lord will plead.
Yeah, the scriptures, bro. Precept upon precept, man.
Oh, you just got condemned, bro.
That's right. Where that? Yeah. Well, what you think we was reading? The book of the day?
Get John 3 and 18, bro.
Did Jay-Z come out with a novel?
Oh, that's truth in that,
though. Can you imagine if he wrote a book?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness, man. I'm surprised how they haven't done no silly shit like that yet, man.
Oh, you know that would sell.
Yeah, it would sell.
But who the hell's going to read it, though? That's the thing.
Them.
You think they would take the time to read that?
No, they'd probably read a couple of chapters in until they get...
Yeah, like, they came, but figure out that many words.
right.
That's too many words. They get confused.
Yeah.
They got to be in bold print with little pictures. It got to be a picture book with a lot of pictures.
Right, yeah.
It's got a lot
of
pictures.
They'll do that, though.
That's how they're going to do it.
They'll do that. You know? Go buy his music and you get this little book with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, get that John. Oh, you want to get it? I'll get it. I was going to get John 3 and 18. Oh, you got to read that loud.
John 3 and 18.
Wait, what?
He that believeth on him is not condemned.
So whoever believes on Yahweh Shai, you are not condemned. Keep going.
But he that believeth not is condemned already.
So if you don't believe in this truth, you're condemned. And the word condemned means with damnation. Okay, it's a Latin word. Keep going.
What truth?
This is the truth.
That's what I'm...
What's not true?
Come here, man. Let's rap, man. Let's just rap. First off,
Adam and Eve was born, right? Was made, right? They had two sons, Cain and Abel, right? One of them killed the other one, right? And the other one went to go marry somebody, right? Who the fuck did he marry? If nobody...
That's what the scriptures tell you. Because there's more than one Adam. Because you don't know the Bible, bro.
I do know the Bible.
You don't know it. So you wouldn't say that.
What did you just say? I didn't catch it because I was reading.
Adam and Eve was put here, right?
Right.
He said where Cain's wife
was. Cain and Abel, right?
Okay.
They had Cain and Abel.
Right.
One of them killed the other one. And the other one went to go marry somebody. Who the fuck did he marry?
Listen, come here. You got to get understanding, man. Because when Adam and Eve was around, it were other people around also.
There's already other people.
There weren't just two people.
The first person was born was a black woman.
No, you go off, man. You got the spirit of a woman.
The oldest bone. Look, I came out a woman.
No.
You
were many. They did. They used to.
If you do your history, if you do your studies, they did. Women can create sperm in their bone marrow.
Oh, you should have stuck with that now, man.
Where they at?
What's that called? That's called a Bothwell gland.
Show me one.
And that Bothwell gland is not shooting out
seed.
It's called a Bothwell gland. They're not shooting out sperm.
It's called the mitochondria, that gland is used to make the pussy wet.
So you're going off on some other crazy shit here. You bugged out with that madness because that gland is used to make the pussy wet. So you can have intercourse.
No, I didn't say
it's not used to.
He's
just saying that the woman impregnate herself.
Why did they come from the bone marrow?
There's some reptiles that does that, man.
I didn't say no gland. That's what we are.
So why do they need
mammals?
Why do they need
mammals? You know what I'm saying? We're not mammals.
This is Adam Eve. Job 31 and 33.
Go ahead.
If I covered my transgression as Adam by hiding my iniquity in my bosom, did I not bear a great multitude? Or did the contempt of families terrify me that I kept silence and would
not
out the door?
You're not saying nothing that I said.
It was a great multitude. What he said, as Adam.
There were many.
I got a scripture. Look.
Adam and Eve, first of all, Adam and Eve means atom, like an atom. and Eve means evolution.
Yeah, cause, no, because...
Let me take you there. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know that, y'all.
That's that hood knowledge, bro.
That ain't no hood knowledge. That's true knowledge.
The word Adam was in the Hebrew first, bro.
That's that nigga.
Yeah, come on with the Adam. Who named that Adam or Adam?
It's called certain homilies. Look that up. Certain homilies that they don't want you talking about because they don't.
We already know. Bro, we done heard everything you already said. Like it was something new. You just use wise. Use the whole wise one. Bro, like we ain't never heard that before. That's some old Jordan Maxwell shit. You know what I mean? Coming out with that old bootlegged ass knowledge. Because look, he didn't want to. He left because he didn't want to hear this. This is Genesis 5:1. This is the book of the generation of Adam. In the day that God created man, in the likeness of God made he him. Male and female created he them, and blessed them, and called their name Adam, in the day when they were created. So it said there was many Adams. There was more than one. It says he called their name Adam. So your boy don't know. He watched a little YouTube video, smoked some weed, and got bugged out. That's what happened. That's what Jake does. He likes to smoke weed and get, you know what I'm saying, they watch the videos, they watch all kind of crazy shit. And then when he get down to it, he gonna tell you the black people come from some distant galaxy or something.
The black woman was the first one created when it says hobby. Oh my God.
Hey, let's get that.
Black woman was the first creator. And I guess she created herself, like he was trying to say.
That's why she's called the wolf man, because she was taking out the man. Okay? That's what she was called. Oh, hell no. Can't go different there, though. He don't give a fuck. What are you looking for? That dude right there is a clown, man. You see that? What are you going? I should get mad at him, though. I mean, that was actually entertaining. It was actually entertaining to hear somebody say such dumbass shit. You know what I mean? Talking about a woman, saying a woman can impregnate herself and make sperm. Where they at, bro? Show me just one and bring her up here and show me that virgin child. People are bugged out their minds, man.
That woman's spirit on the bed. They won't believe God. They can't see him. Nobody seen a woman have a fucking baby by herself.
And it's the same people that got that womanly spirit that won't come out and push the truth like we do. Week in and week out, you know? They gonna be steadily making videos all the time. They just fucking... Man, go ahead.
Spirit is 11 and 8. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man.
That's common sense. That's why when you get married, the woman takes your last name. That's common damn sense. You know, this has been common sense since the beginning of fucking time. You know what I'm saying? That's why let's get that Isaiah. Isaiah 4:1. In that day, seven women shall take hold of one man. Or maybe it means seven men shall take hold of one woman, though, right? In that day, seven women shall take hold of one man. We will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. You know what I'm saying? So a woman, they take the name of the man. That's why when you marry a woman, she takes your last name. Like I said, that's why a woman's called a woman. Because she came from the man.
For the man, neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man.
But actually, when you go into that ancient Egyptian shit, I'm pretty sure I read some bugged out stories about the sperm or something. And it always said that everything came from seeds. Like even the Babylonian devil worshippers, their creation story involves some gods jizzing all over the place. You know what I mean? It's just some nasty, mind of a heathen. And then you got other stories saying shit came from an egg, the cosmic egg. These people are bugged out of their fucking minds. Right, if the woman's so great in Egypt, then how come their top guy was a man, though? Right?
Good question.
First Timothy 2:13. For Adam was first formed, then Eve.
He had a spirit of a faggot.
For real, he did have that feminine ass spirit, bro. And he was over there. He got angry. After he said the Bible was bullshit or something, he started dancing. Like, he got so angry, he said something. He was proud of himself. He did a little jig. People are bugged out, bro. It ain't surprising, though. Look who he's raised by. You know he was raised by a woman. That's obvious. That's crazy.
What the fuck? This is Romans 1 and 23. 21. Because that, when they knew the Most High, they glorified him not as God, neither were thinking, but became vain in their imaginations.
That's
their
a thing.
Foolish hearts was darkened.
Yeah, the foolish heart, that's beyond foolishness, man. I mean, to believe something like that, how stupid you gotta be? But how stupid you gotta be to believe that a woman can impregnate herself? To believe that, just tell, I mean, it just don't take a genius to figure this one out, bro.
Stupid.
I mean, this is kind of fucking sense.
Stupid.
To get pregnant, you gotta have sex. That's just a fact.
So the minds are simple. Like we was talking about, just gave us an example that, simple belief is everywhere.
For real. You know? They really do. They are people are simple, bro. They believe anything. Huh? That's good. The war does not go out void.
Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools.
That's beyond foolishness, man. That's some whole nother shit.
Get out of here. Yeah, right.
Even come to
that's crazy.
You should have told
me. I ain't never heard of
it. Yeah, that's crazy.
That's that Egyptian philosophy.
That's
some bullshit. That's some bullshit. That's what it is.
That's what it is. Yeah, godlike. I know that.
That's right.
And it's only somebody that would say, he said the Bible.
One thing I can say, the Bible got raped by the black man. Was like, whatever it is. And then, you decide to uplift. That's where it's missing in action.
Hey, some of these crazy people will say that they get
that's
the kind
where,
of the
that's
Satan.
That's where that person is missing in action. I'm going to look at what they talk about.
I'm going to take
time. Because he's so scared. Yeah, you need a check. Real quick.
Hey, your boy worked at a hospital too, bro.
Oh, you kidding me,
bro? The dude that came up
with that's the uniform he had on?
It looked like a nurse outfit or something.
Right, bro.
So just think, he's up there taking care of people. What kind of weird shit is he doing? You want that guy taking care of you?
He got a back.
He said the black man is not
Yeah, that thing is over.
gotta pay child support.
You know what I mean?
He needs to go get a check right down the street.
Social security right here, something.
Oh, yeah, he's back out of the professed to have some wisdom. He said the Bible was bullshit. He was all smiling. Thought he had all the knowledge. Then he said some bullshit and ran away. Then he let us get this explained to him. Hey, he heard it though. I yelled the scripture on the bus. You can hear that. I was loud as hell.
Now I beseech you, brother, mark them which are divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned and avoid them.
Yeah, that's that one of them conscientious community motherfuckers. They claim to be conscious. But being conscious only means that you're a weirdo and that you believe in some bugged out shit. Saying women. And then I guarantee you, because you already know what kind of stuff he's into.
Are y'all the same people as the ones that have on the bread, bro? I heard about them. They in with the Illuminati.
They're MKs.
Okay. They on YouTube. And they got them under the MKs. And it's they out here and manifest their
congregation of
more than 20 million.
She white though.
Yeah, you talking about the MK Ultra?
Yeah, that's exactly what they're doing.
I said, you two is on point. You two ain't playing. And like I said, you better wake the F up. Wake up. For real. Because it's real. That stuff is real.
Wake the fuck up. Wake out of sleep.
And it's like I said, and they deal with numbers too. That was a genius idea. 911. The hit on that calendar day, September the 9th, 11th day, 911. Genius. And that's how they deal. That's how they get you. That's for death. That's how they get you death.
Yeah, you know, Rolo became king of Duke of Normandy in 9/11. You know, Rolo, he was the forefather of the Viking kings of England.
Right.
Like, you know, like Lionheart, King Lionheart. That was his. He was the head of the house going back. That he's the one that started it. Yeah, 9/11. That's just, you know, they probably use
numerology.
You know, they use the numbers all the time.
Most I do numbers too. For they that are such serve not our Lord Yahweh Shah, but their own fellow. And by good words and fair speeches, deceive the hearts of many.
And it's not hard to deceive the hearts of many either. It's an easy thing to do. Well, you know what's hard is teaching somebody the truth. That's the hard part. That's why they call this what we're doing is work. You out here working.
Woo!
That's some hard work trying to wake these fools up. You know what I mean?
I hate when they run, though, man. I just hate that, man. They gotta stay.
They always run, yeah.
I'm going back to this wrong chapter. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools and changed the glory of their uncorruptible power into an image made to corruptible man and to birds and to four-footed beasts and creeping things. Wherefore Yahweh Shai also gave them up to uncleanness through their lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves.
See, because you know what that doctrine, what your boy is teaching, because this is talking about the homosexuals, you know, transvestites, all that, faggots and stuff. But that doctrine and that teaching that a woman can impregnate herself, what does that lead to?
Nothing.
No, homosexuality. Because they also teach that a penis is an overgrown clit. They actually teach, that's what the Egyptologists teach. I just watched the videos. You know your boy watching the same video. You know he believes it. If we got that far, he'd probably say, yeah, that's a penis of the clit. That's what they teach.
They're all selling their souls for money.
Yep.
Looper. Selling money is for looper.
They price.
They cheddar.
That's stupid.
You know a nigga love money.
Yep, they did, but not only them. All nationalities.
They say,
what's up, bro?
I'd rather stay broke.
No regular man, you guys really turn a bus. When you go one direction on the bus, you can't ride.
What's up, bro?
The opposite direction on the same bus.
I just have no idea.
What are y'all doing out here? Teaching the Bible. I've been doing this for years.
I didn't know that.
Bro.
I mean, I guess we don't talk about it.
I'm unable to use it. Anybody else, Spirit?
That's right.
Now we're asking if we're using the transfer.
Do you smoke non-menthol cigarettes?
I smoke, but I don't have one.
I'm just saying.
What's happening?
I don't understand.
I'm gonna get
on that.
I can use a smoke gun, man. I don't have any.
Do you have a question?
Okay.
Hey, thanks, man. Anybody can spare 75 cents to get on the bus.
Sorry, bro.
So ahead, you guys just videotaping y'all are doing?
Right on.
I thought I saw that.
You know what? They don't mess the game up for everybody.
I thought I saw that.
You feel me?
Yeah, we've been coming out here for
about
8 years now.
What is your religion?
We don't get due to religion. I mean, religion's a bad word, bro. That's like a curse word.
Yeah, it's about ritual.
Yeah. We just believe what the Bible says. The Bible says, you know, the one they call Jesus, he came to save Israel, the Israelites. So really, we're a nation of people. A lot of people don't know, you probably Israelites. We descend from the ancient Israelites of the Bible. And this is the record of our forefathers.
Right?
Oh, yeah, I know you got
Oh, you like that? Oh, yeah, that's just a bunch of shit that I did in 2006.
Okay, then stand.
That's
stand,
where my head was at.
We'll swap. Because ain't nobody else.
Yeah, I'll give you a scripture.
Yeah,
my parents were Pentecostal.
Oh, yeah.
They were Christians. They had prayer meetings at their house. I know I've read the Bible probably twice. I was down with it when I was a young teenager. Because I was smoking weed and shit when I was 10, and I started feeling like I wasn't supposed to be doing that. So my parents went to a Pentecostal church, and they were taking me with them, of course. I was only like 15. And I got saved. But it didn't last very long. I stayed sober probably for about 9 months. 10 months, and then I started smoking weed again. And just the only reason I went to church was so I could sneak out. My parents didn't mind me not sitting with them. So I'd go up in the balcony, and when they weren't looking, I'd sneak out and go to the pinball game, the arcade.
Yeah, well, the same with these churches, though, because most of their teaching, to be blunt, is a bunch of bullshit. They're not really teaching the Bible properly.
Yeah, the word hell doesn't even, I don't even know.
Right, the word hell, actually, that's a good point, because hell is the name of Norse mythology. You got Thor and Loki.
Yeah.
Loki has a daughter. Her name was Hel, and she was the goddess of the underworld.
Right.
So when you look that word Hel up in the original Greek text, the word there is Gehenna. And Gehenna was an actual place on Earth. It was a place south of Jerusalem. It's where they burn trash. It's where, you know, people sacrifice children to Baal. So when he says you're in danger of hellfire, it's like a metaphor for destruction, saying you're going to be burned up. And the scripture says the Lord is merciful.
Yeah, absolutely. That's always been where I've been.
Right, yeah. We don't believe in that doctrine of hell, everlasting punishment. You know, that's just like a metaphor for destruction.
Sure.
There it is. Hell never exists.
That's what I believe pretty much all my life. Even when I was a little kid in Sunday school, they were talking about all this stuff that was going on, and I was like, about hell, and about the three wise men, not the three wise men, but the three men in the fiery furnace and all that.
Oh, yeah.
When I was like 5-6 years old, they were telling me that, and I was thinking, that don't sound right, man. I was a skeptic from the beginning.
Really, this out here is hell.
That's what I, when I started coming into like my teenage years and listening to what these preachers were saying, I was like, that's got to be about you know, scaring people into.
Yeah, it is. That's what it is, to control people. Yeah. You know?
Scare attack.
That you know that.
Revelation 20:14. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire.
Oh, yeah, this is Revelation. It says death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. Go ahead. That's the second death. So a lot of people like to say the lake of fire is hell. They don't understand that either. The lake of fire is a destruction's cover.
It's metaphorical.
Well, it said it was the second death.
A lot of people think it's nuclear.
Oh, right. That is. That's what it is. If you read the scriptures, there's two deaths. The first one was death by water with the flood.
Right.
And the Lord promised, he said, I'll never flood the earth again. But the next destruction is coming with fire. And that's all through the Bible. You know, if you believe in the, you know, the end times prophecy. The scriptures talk about that great fire, that great day of judgment.
Listen, this is Malachi 4:1. So, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. What else could cause that? You know, think about it. Just think about World War II, when the U.S. when they dropped those bombs on.
That was a little tiny one.
Right.
That was the first one.
Those were firecrackers. Firecrackers compared to what they got now.
They got nukes that can take out a whole state. And they're going to use them eventually.
Yeah, that's what we're reading. For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. You know, the root of branch represent ways of the rebuild back up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Branch grows leaves.
This whole place, this whole world is going to be rooted out.
Right. It's going to be totally victorious.
After the rapture?
No, that is good.
Well, the rapture, yeah, that's a whole thing. Because you got the crazy rapture doctrines they got in the churches. But
you know what rapture means.
Bigger than that.
It means to take.
To take away. It means the same thing as rape.
Rape,
it means to take away. So, yeah, we will be taken away. The scriptures say the Lord's going to come out of the clouds and pretty much beam us up.
Yeah.
You know, like, because the scriptures talk about, this is where you get crazy, the scriptures go to UFOs. You know what I'm saying?
It's a mystery, boy.
Yeah.
That we love.
Yeah, that's what's mystery.
You know, I believe what you're saying about the metaphorical. I've always believed that.
Yeah.
You know, Revelations especially. People are like, man, that's not going to happen. That's too crazy.
Yeah.
But John wasn't talking about he didn't know what a fucking fighter plane was.
Right, he described
locusts.
Yeah, locusts.
Huge locusts, stuff like that.
Right, because they didn't have the machines back then.
No.
Yeah, the Bible, you know, it's some crazy stuff in the Bible.
Yeah.
People get bugged out on it too.
Like,
if you know, people that haven't had proper instruction and learning, because you got to study. So if people don't have proper teachers and you know they don't study, you just can't open the book up and just start reading it.
Yeah, not too many people know that the Bible was in Greek first.
Oh yeah, they don't even know that. Yeah.
Yeah.
The New Testament is in Greek and the Old Testament is Hebrew.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But yeah, we studied the Greek and Hebrew. To get a full understanding, you have to go back to the original language.
That's my bus, man.
All right, brother, man. Good talking to you. I'll see you. He's a well, I don't want to throw his business. Well, he's in the AA. You know how my mom be doing that shit. But he's in that. You know, that's his business. But that AA shit does not work. I just seen a study came out in the news like a week or so ago, and they say that AA, Alcoholics Anonymous, had a 20% success rate. Hey, nobody stays sober.
It's true.
It's horrible.
It's like the right mind would notice this.
Exactly.
You know?
But you know, it's all about...
That's what the suicide mentioned. Only fools. So walk around, talking about Jesus loves you. Love Jesus. Jesus loves you.
It might work for some people.
Jesus? Who's Jesus? John!
Yeah, because I've seen it time and time again, people falling, what do you call falling off the wagon?
Yeah, no disrespect, man. I definitely had the gentleman that was just snapping and talking to me, you know what I mean? I had a little with the guys talking on religion and everything like that. Yeah, he actually just saw it out of the blue, just here, man. And gave me what would you, because if you were, would you have done, I mean, just
maybe you guys were discussing. You say maybe we'll just go. It's very, very honest. It might be just Agent 5 cigarettes. They can go here, man.
Well, he just finally the chick smoking anyway.
Well, yeah, you
should. I ain't had nobody on shit.
I don't know.
That's being unlawful and unrighteous.
There it is. That's what I'm asking you. There it is.
You smoke a cigarette, man.
That's part of them addictions, boy. Block, I used to smoke. I used to smoke
cigarettes last week, 3 days, man.
I used to smoke cigarettes. That was the best thing I ever did was quit. One day I just said, "The hell, this shit."
Nicotine is the most addicting drug that they found so far.
They said.